Hallelujah. We, I will start from the beginning onwards. Whatever the classes that Brother Thomas Paul gave to us, it was inspiring for me. At a such a age, old age, he is giving us this much inspiring thoughts and very energetic towards catechism of the Catholic Church and evangelization. It is very much amazement, astonishing for me that as a such a old age, he is giving this much of his life for evangelization. The stories which he told, it was very funny and interesting and very nice. Then, starting of the class, he said about that Jesus called his disciples. He gave them power to cast out demons and power. Cast out demons, authority over demons, and send them. Jesus does not send them just as go and do these things. He also gave them the power. Likewise, when we evangelize, Jesus will give us the power. And when he came to the earth, it is that he incarnate on the earth for us mankind, so that we may be divine. As brother showed us the candle, red and white, red that represents the Jesus, and white that are we. So the flame that passes through red to white, it is something miraculous for us that God is giving his own life, as it is in Genesis that God gave his own spirit to human, and that we are alive here. It is his own grace. Then coming to next, it is in CCC 460, brother said that in Catechism of Catholic Church, word became flesh and make us partners of divine. It is that the word of God that became flesh stayed with us and he gave his life for us, just for us. He does not think about anything. He fulfilled the wish of his Father in heaven. Then he also told about us many saints like Saint Catherine of Siena. She was not studied. She did not study, even educated, not degree, nothing. All then also she was able to guide the Pope and all. It is a great gift of God that she is. She did for our Catholic Church. Then the Saint Therese, then Saint Margaret Maria and Faustina, they are the inspiring saint for us who gave their life for, not gave their life, they gave their life for Jesus, only for Jesus, not for somebody else. Then coming to next, he told us about the Holy Spirit. Actually, this full class was about the Holy Spirit only. These 3 days, he told us many things about the Holy Spirit, that how does the Holy Spirit works, how he gives us his visions and all his blessings, graces. Then he also told about the graces. First of all, if we say about graces, we don't have any perfect definition of graces, but the Reverend Brother gave us the definition of grace, that it is the grace is the participation of God or divine life into a human life. He also showed us the example like this that I will remember every day. Then the grace, it is very much astonishing for us that he is giving his life, his something for us. Then he also told about who are the Christians. I am remembering the word that my rector told me, that we are the people who are not of this world. God will take us from this world. We live in this world, we are from this world, but we are not from here. Likewise, brother also told that a Christian live in this world, but he is something more than this world. Then coming, he also told us about that we should be holy. Then about our charisms and all, If we talk about charisms, everybody have their own charism, but nobody will think that our vocation is a charism. Even I was also not thinking that our vocation is a charism, but brother said that our vocation is a charism. Our vocation to a religious life, a priest, and as a brother got vocation for his family life, he said that this is also a charism to lead a family, and our charism to lead the church and all. Then he also told about his prayer life. It was very much astonishing for me that he is getting up morning at 3 o'clock and praying. Even now I am so young, I am not getting at 3 o'clock. Sometimes 5:30, 6 it goes. Then he also told that about the wisdom, chapter 13 verse 5, I think so, that early morning that she waits for us, the wisdom. It is wisdom 6:14 that says that wisdom early in the morning she is waiting for us. Very nice that somebody is waiting for us outside. And he also said about that holy kurbana, the bread and the wine and everything. It was a wish. Everybody is here to be a religious or to be a priest, to be a nun. So it is very much important for us to know about the Holy Kurbana. So he also told us about the Holy Kurbana, incarnation, the 8 mysteries. First he said 7 mysteries, then he told 8. The first one is the mystery of incarnation, then mystery of baptism, then public proclamation, passion and death, the mystery of resurrection, the annunciation, the Pentecost, and the coming of Jesus. In this, something is very important that brother is observing everything very clearly. He understands everything clearly. Then even though if we are go to some priest or we brothers only, if you see, they will not say everything about this. I think I should give thanks to brother that giving this much knowledge to us. Then he has also said that in Holy Kurbana, Christ manifests, he makes presence, he communicates the work of the salvation. The communication of the work of salvation is for us, and it is for us to spread, to give to the world. Then he also, said that he said many things about the Holy Spirit. Many word of God is given by brother to us. Not by brother, it is in Bible he said to us. Then he, it is written in John 15:26, when the advocate comes, whom I will send you, he will reveal you everything. Means it is a promise from God that somebody will come for our help. In this world, in now present, even the best friend is not coming for help. It is a God's promise, very much inspiring for me. Then likewise, in John 14:26, the Father will send the advocate which will teach you everything and remind you all. Means the Father will send the advocate which will remind all the things that Jesus taught us in the beginning that we don't know, but he will remind us. That is there. And at last I will share my opinion to you all that when we are praying for the workshop over each other's heads, it is my experience that first time that I was praying for somebody keeping my hand on him or her. I do not believe that is with my hand this is possible, because such a sinful person I am. It is something very much great gift for us that Holy Spirit is working through us. It is not just for joking, it is really that Holy Spirit is working through us. He is giving us the visions and all. Then I will, whenever the brother gave us the examples that whenever he go for some retreat, anything else, he talks to the Holy Spirit. If somebody is calling us in, when we walk through the road, if somebody is calling us, we will say that who is calling us? Nobody is there. We will go reject and we will go. But in this era, brother is believing that Holy Spirit is working and he is calling him. And here are some people, some brothers, some outsiders, they don't believe in the Holy Spirit at all. Then he also said that the presence of the Holy Spirit is important for every work. Without the help of the Holy Spirit, nothing is impossible. And it is written on the board that Lucas 1:37, that nothing is impossible for God. Like this, it is, nothing is impossible for God. He will send His Spirit to us and it will make everything possible. As I said, that the Word of God can give life to everybody, it means even the dead, who was Lazarus, who was for 4 days in the tomb, he got alive. If now we are going in any tomb and all, if we say that he will be getting alive, nobody will believe, everybody will laugh and go, that's all. Like that same situation was with Jesus, but he believed in his Father and the Spirit was working through him and he got alive. This retreat was something for me with something means very much something for me. Before coming here on the stage, this is my second time. Every time my heart is beating this much that I will get the heart attack and all. As I reach to there, then I will say, Holy Spirit, help me. Then I don't know, when I come here, everything is fine and okay. Everything is going good, fine. And in our religious life, I think if Holy Spirit is with us, everything is possible. Nothing is impossible. And it is now we are for evangelization. Brother took the retreat for evangelization. It is very good for us that somebody is here for evangelization. Nowadays, if you go to any priest and all, they will say, I will be in AC and all. They will say like that. Even now, young priest and sisters also, they are not coming out in this hot summer for us. And the brother is taking us for retreat in this hot climate and this much scorching sun and all. Heartfelt gratitude towards you that you gave us this beautiful retreat. For this, now I concluding my words here. Whatever I said, it was from the Holy Spirit. I did not prepare anything. Just I wrote the points. Even now you can see it is here and there. Nothing is wrote clearly. But the Holy Spirit, even now I am not understanding my handwriting also. But it is by the Holy Spirit that does everything. So praise the Lord. Thank you for your retreat, brother.